Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, my Ogbonge people, my Biafran people, lovers of freedom, my fellow freedom fighters. Wherever you dare, may the peace of the Lord may it shine upon you. May the hand of the Lord be with you. May whatever you do, may you prosper. Amen. My brothers and sisters, the video we won't watch. Now the invasion of Nigerian terrorist government for our brother, Ifeanyi Ejiofor. And the kind carnage where these people want commit for that compound. But this God where they in heaven say, now you be man, now me be God. Even in the book of Psalm 24 verse 4 say, he who must come to equity, he must come with a clean hand. My dear brothers and sisters, the thing where God, where my heart they bother me since that day. Now the time and the hour where that thing took place and the death of TB Joshua, this evil terrorist government, they won't make Ifeanyi Ejiofor death and the death of TB Joshua happen the same time. So that the death of TB Joshua in go carry the death of Ifeanyi Ejiofor come put on for carpet. But this Elohim, where will they serve? He said, no, it no go happen. As you watch him now this video, my brothers and sisters, I want make you give me your thought down below. But the thing why may I show you be say, Biafra is here and nobody can stop it. He say,
what I'm trying to show here is what actually occurred, what happened on that 6th of June when the Nigerian Task Force invaded by Ifeanyi Ejiofor's compound in order to assassinate him. This is the second attempt after the one that occurred on 2nd of December 2019. And the second one now is the one that happened on 6th of June 2021. This camera screen of various CCTV being placed in various angles. And then in my front here, we have a camera 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 7 faces of the camera placed in various angles.
This camera footage shows clearly the bloody invasion of Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor and Sisters in the Anambra State on the 6th of June 2021. So this one is the camera behind the building. Camera behind this camera, okay, this one is camera one, this is camera two, then this is the main entrance. So as soon as they came, this camera captured when they were coming, and we have to reproduce it in the course of this analysis. So as soon as they approached the gate, trying to force themselves inside the premise, inside the compound, one of them probably discovered that the camera at the gate and broke it. That was when the camera stopped showing. Same happens to this camera too. But fortunately, before the cameras number one and two were tampered with, the cameras were able to capture vividly, clearly how they came in and how in the manner in which they, and the kind of ammunitions they came along with and how sophisticated they were and also the formations of the JTF. So this camera, third camera, is the one within the compound. This camera shows clearly what the atrocities they committed inside Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor's house. It shows how his domestic staff were abducted, how his personal assistant Samuel Okoro, alias Biggie, this CCTV showed it, this CCTV footage showed it, was killed right inside the room. So there was no any form of, as can be shown through this CCTV, there was no any form of resistance from the domestic staff of Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor when they came in. All of them were standing still. Then the few of them were brought outside, they were standing still, there was no form of resistance. So the other person, the PA, who was designed to be killed, as instructed and funded them to do, was also assassinated after injecting with lethal substance. This camera number three also showed when he was, the lifeless body was being evacuated from the premises, captured him. You can see where they're moving, they're marching, participating in the force here. You can see him, can see them in their numbers. As if there's any war going on in a peaceful, in a lawyer's peaceful home. That's what's obtainable in Nigeria. See, you can see it. You can see them, you can see the soldiers. These are people who abandoned their duty post at Sambesa Forest to launch a bloody onslaught in a peaceful home. A barrister of international report. You can see it. You can see them. Okay. So you can see the soldiers. So nobody would deny the fact that security joint task force, heavily led by another direct command of AIG Jonah Bank. It will also be brought to mind that Jonah Bank was the person who killed Yusuf, the founder of Boko Haram. And on account of that death, Boko Haram has spread across the entire northeast, northwest, and all over the world, all over the north. Today, the rising seasons, the rising also the security agents. So because of what Donna Bank AIG did, and unfortunately, we're still serving today actively in the police, Nigerian police force. So today, he sent his men to come to Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor on 6th of June 2021, house, a peaceful home, a lawyer's home, to kill.
This is Nigerian army. This is soldier. Look at it very well. This is soldier. Look at him wearing army uniform. So now they are joint team. This one is police. This one is soldier. At least we've seen two soldiers. Yeah. This is Nigerian army. They are dragging the young man. Dragging him. The soldiers that took him out of the gate. They took him out of the gate. This is Nigerian soldier. You see the uniform? It's very, very obvious. See Nigerian soldier here. Nigerian army.
You can see his brother, how the house been, the other brother, Joel Ejiofor, how he was being dragged to the camp. See him. Harmless and innocent citizens. People, there was no any form of resistance. If you are investigating any case against a lawyer, it's not supposed to be extended an invitation. Or even come in the daytime, let's see people who are in his house. So, but this time around, they choose to come at the wee hours of the night because they have some evil intention. They have an evil intention, evil design. And also, as you can see, they park their cars. About 15 Hilux vehicles, including a motor personal carrier, about 3 kilometers away from his house, before they came down to this place. So I know there will no traces of them will be covered by the city camera, which camera. So we cannot get their footage, the foot of the vehicle, the vehicle, the vehicle numbers, the type of vehicle they came with cannot be seen through that cameras. So they park about 3 kilometers away from his house, and threat to his house to commit this murder. So you can see what they are doing here. Camera capture everything clearly. So they can't deny this fact. You can see how they're coming in. You can see them moving in. At this point, they have killed Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor PA. If you watch closely, you see as they were about to evacuate him, like the lifeless body from the house. And that, as if that's not enough, they forced the driver to hand over the car key, this Toyota camera car.
Okay, now see what's going on. They've taken the vehicle. What they did now, they have to force and collect key from my Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor driver. They collected the key from him in order to drive out. Remember, the car was there at the car park before they came in. Now they've taken the vehicle out.
This is a clear case of murder, a clear case of abduction, a clear case of stealing. You can see them, a clear case of stealing of cars. And in Nigeria, decision: police would kill somebody in a peaceful home where they came on a supposed investigation or acted on a supposed false intelligence who never posed any form of resistance to them, who was harmless, then put the dead body inside his red car, took him away to a far distance and burnt him. The essence of burning this body is to destroy any evidence of what the kind of substance they use in killing him, to destroy it. So during the autopsy, test. So that's what may be the reason why, most likely may be the reason why they burned this car. So this is a person who never posed any form of, you can see the driver being dragged on the floor of the compound. This is a person who never posed any form of challenge to the stance to this. You can see that how they were all abducted. Nobody was armed, nobody even raised a voice. So, and you can see them shooting, they're shooting gun now into the air. As I have seen, the shooting gun into the air, into the air. To wait off any form of attack on them. So, but unfortunately, this is a peaceful home. This is not some bizarre forest where they will see such attack. So you will see them now coming back to take over this, to drag away this car. So, and this car was subsequently that night bought along. See this man that drove the car along with the PA, the level of the PA to Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor at name in another local government by a Kata police station. This car, as we speak today, It's still there. Skeleton of this car is still there. Up to date, this was about 2 weeks or about after the incident, after the bloody onslaught in his home. No one in the police, even you can see them driving the car. This is a car, had earned money of a lawyer. They damn drove this car away from the house. Not that this car is under any form of investigation. They went somewhere and burnt it. So it's important for the international community to look at this, investigate it. Thankfully, the foreign government have still invested on this matter and is getting it today. So it's important that the world watch what happened here, because this thing will go viral. And the dates of this people, this has to be in the course of time unveiled, because we capture them clearly more than this. So we are calling on international bodies to also investigate and request prevail on the government to identify these criminals these criminals in uniforms and made them public, prosecute them accordingly. That's what we are. The family is asking, the family of Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofo, and also Ifeanyi Ejiofo is asking the world to do. You can see them driving the car. He's got the car, driving away the car, had them money of a lawyer. Not that the car was, it's subject of any investigation, and went outside and burned it. Today, the CP, Commissioner of Police Anambra State, made prompt contact with Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofo on Sunday. The bomb, the fire that the state commander was involved in the attempted assassination of his and also the killing of his PA, or what the policeman JTF did in his house. So he was not involved, he was not informed at that point. They are coming. He was not aware of the operation. So neither was the area commander, the chair of this command, was informed. So this operation was carried out under the direct order of AIG John Abank. So we are calling on the international community to look into this matter. As we progress, we're going to make more chilling revelations as contained in the footage about what happened.